Yeah, that's the plan. And these are the maps. This one is Malana Valley.
It doesn't drop from your fingers, so sticky it is. It's incredible. And so intense the aroma. You can smell in it the mountains. You can smell a little bit of resin from pine trees, a little bit. It's so complex, it's incredible.
The place in India where we are going, in the mountains, it's famous for its charas. How is it made? This is one of the reasons that we are going to this place, is this is one of the few places in the world where they make the hash from live plants.
This is the best cream produced in the Himalayas, and we're gonna make sure that when we come back, we will bring back with us the knowledge, the precious knowledge that Franco Casalone and that many other people have about that area and about this kind of quality. This is cannabis cup winner quality stuff.
For me, it's very interesting and very nice, both to go back in India and to work to make something for this plant, because I told you, for me, it's my life.
The Indian expedition started with a really cool trip from Amsterdam. After a great dinner and a good night of sleep, we went to the airport, boarded the KLM flight, and in 8 hours we were in India.
Simon!
No way, Simon!
Fortunately, our great friend Simon was waiting for us in Chokki. Came all the way from Africa, and it's always a surprise, do people arrive on time or not?
We travel long distances to meet each other, and communication is quite difficult sometimes, so it was really a cool experience and a cool thing to find him there waiting for us. At the temple there was a ceremony going on, so in our honor and in honor of the Shiva, god of charas, we witnessed this ceremony.
Also very important, these traditional cultures here in India, was a suggestion from our Sherpa here, Chapu. We also decided to offer a goat to the gods for our well-being into the mountains.
And it was pretty amazing, pretty unique, quite intense experience. You could really feel the vibration of something special in the air.
Man,
look at this church.
This church, yeah.
You see that?
This is church. Wow.
The first ones in India.
It's a bit covered
look
in
the resin, eh?
Man. Yeah, man. These are the original color seeds, man. Look at this. Incredible.
This green one. This one, eh?
No. Green.
Green.
Yes.
Yeah. Church.
Yeah, green. This side,
yellow.
Yeah.
This one here, lemon haze. What do you think about all the females? Because it's only females, eh?
Yeah, sirp larkibuti.
What did you say?
These males are not good. This is the good part.
100% greenhouse feminized quality. No doubt.
In the Himalayas.
In the Himalayas. This is gonna be a nice smoke. In the Himalayas as well as in Africa. This one performs well everywhere, this plant.
And it's full of seeds, eh?
Yeah.
In the morning in the Kulu, and the first thing we did, of course, is smell and taste some culture of the area. So we decided to have a little walk on the market, a very colorful market with all beautiful clothes and people and a kind of circus, young children doing things that you can question if it's good or not, but this is India. Compared to Europe, it's incredible. Also, the prices and the labor and the people who are working there. You see the ice cream vendors with their ISO patent little cars.
Dussehra Festival is a festival they make to remember the victory of the god Rama against a devil who was living in Sri Lanka and who raped his wife Sita. Hundreds of thousands of people, they will come, because here in any village there is a different god. So in this particular day, all the gods will go in Kulu.
We got on the main square, and all these gods, these personifications of gods, came running through the streets, parading through the streets, and the army was there, an incredible amount of soldiers.
Thousands of gods come together, also our god Shiva, the Ganja god.
The festival was really colorful, was something that for me was unique to see, also because you can feel the culture, how it impregnates the life of the people here.
It was a big riot in the end. But it was beautiful to be a part of this festival.
The Mahindra in India is like a classic. You know, if you drive around, you see thousands of these old Mahindra jeeps. And for us, it was really nice to be able to drive and get the feeling of the real India on the road. Compared to other countries where we are able to get a bit more modern and a bit more efficient 4x4s, actually it was a little bit of a step back, but we adapt and we move on and we drive on. After a few hours in the car, we reached the bottom of Malana Valley, and that's where the walk begins. And the walk is pretty steep. Immediately it starts with a good session all the way up to 2,700 meters. And that's where the incredible character Galeno lives.
Galeno!
Acha, my hand is very good.
We walked okay. Up to Galeno, an Italian man who's living for 24 years on that mountain.
He's one of these crazy hippie character who lives in his own world, but he creates something very special and very magical around him.
and he knows a lot about hand rubbing and making charas. He grows his own vegetables. He lives in his own monoculture nearly there. He's got all different kinds of things, and he made also a very nice woolen sweater for me for in the cold.
Yeah, yeah.
Perfect.
Fits.
Kike.
He decided to come here and to forget this fucking new world.
Galena was pure poetry. It was unbelievable to find him living there. Inspirational at his age. He's so strong and healthy, his mind is so clear.
All that counts for him is writing poetry, smoking good charas in the chillum, and having positive vibes and positive energy with the people and the animals and the plants around him.
Oltre al canto degli uccelli, ciò che allieta il mio mattino sono i 5 o 6 spinelli, a dir poco, che mi fumo accanto al fuoco. Means that there are in the morning time, no, the singing of the birds, no, and this makes me
happy.
But it's not only this that in the morning I am happy, because I help for the happiness, smoking 5-6 joint, at least.
At least.
At least.
We decided to camp on 2700, very close to where Franco have lived for a very long time, in his cave.
He told me about the cave many times, but when you see it in person, then it's really incredible. You see this place, the view alone is out of this planet, and you think so peaceful, so magical, with plants around, fields around, a small community of mountain people which are very welcoming and very friendly.
When I arrived here, it was opening. Then the locals, they told me there was a house there broken. They told me you take stones and wood and you fit it. And they helped me, they fit it.
When did you came here?
96.
96?
96. How many years did you live here?
10 years.
You're 10 years in the cave?
Yeah.
First time I was in this area, it was in 91. Then I was amazed from these Himalayas, really. Then in 94, I had the trouble in Italy. So I had my strays. I decided to give them a chance. In the spring of 96, I was here asking to the locals if it was possible to give them some chance. They told me, yes, you can do it. Then I started on living here. But I realized was not only for this, all this kind of life is so interesting.
This is incredible, man. Beautiful resin.
You take a little bit of the leaves off.
They start to have black seeds, huh? You see?
Yeah, they're nearly ready, yeah?
They start ripening.
It's good for making cream, like this.
The original hand way of making charas.
Rubbing it.
The big difference with Morocco is where they dry the plants, but here you have to do it all alive.
We decided to build the base camp there because after that we could walk for another few hours up to 3,000, 3,200 to very special fields.
And these fields are amazing. The genetics there are actually very, very special, because you can see many phenotypes of this same kind of landrace that generates this incredible charas and incredible cream. And in the same field you can see purple plants, you can see sweet flowery plants, you can see real sativas with a minty, piney, woody smell, and a very, very nice variation. So very interesting from a plant point of view also.
So it takes you a whole day to make one tola.
It will be very difficult now to make one tola in one day.
Wow.
Yeah. It will be...
Maybe half tola, no?
Maybe 6-7 grams maximum.
6-7 grams. A tola in India is 10 grams, so now they make 6-7 grams.
Then
you have to work
hard.
One full day of work, imagine.
camping as a strain hunter is also a little bit a different experience than people imagine, because of course the kind of time and time frame you have is always very short. You have to set up tent at the end of the day and leave your camp very early in the morning, so you don't have much time to prepare much to eat, or you just have time to make a nice big fire that we always take care of doing, because it's safe and gets you warm. It's very important.
Traveling from Malawi to India is obviously quite a shock. Massive differences, obviously, in terms of altitude and terrain, and also in terms of how people plant. In Malawi, you'd find this tiny little field hidden miles and miles away, really like a needle in a haystack, whereas in India, you really just hit that ganja is everywhere.
After the cave, we kept moving until we finally reached the top fields.
Franco showed us how the original cream is made now, and this is something the foreigners brought in like 15 years ago, because it used to be only charas, and now they also make cream. This is a high quality with less particulates of the plant in, like no hairs and no calyxes and no wood.
Hey, wait a second. 3,000 meters, man.
And for us, it was also a very big learning experience to see from which area the best cream or best charas come. What we really saw is that the higher you get, the higher the quality of the cream gets, and also the more indica the plant gets.
This is the field. How many plants are here?
Here are a few millions all around. So the plants we have to choose, they should be ripened, but not fully ripened. They should have not one dry point of the little leaves also to make cream.
The cream,
We all sat in a circle and Franco started teaching us how to make the perfect hand of charas and the perfect hand of cream. And it was just incredible. We just sat there in the sun. It was such a beautiful day with this crispy mountain air. And we started rubbing.
So the hands are totally clean. Nothing on the hands, no cream, no nothing. The hands must be in the sun, what Franco explained to us. And I better the face away from the sun because it's a long hot day. Then you slowly rub the plants in the manicure first.
One by one. Some people, they will clean all before, all together. But they will start to let some juice if you clean all before. It's better. For better quality, it's better to clean one by one.
Rubbing in the Himalayas, King. This feels pretty cool.
The stem you should take away. Then a bud we put in the hands, and we start to caress it. Very gently, very slowly, and without pressure. We just must to feel it, to rub in your hands. In your palms, in your fingers, without breaking anything.
Look already, you see the
stitching.
Is this big? Is it big?
It's too big, yes. It's better to make too little together. When you strip it, you don't make like this, because this.
That's plant juice.
This will take away the charas from your head. You try to take, to let it, the big piece on your fingers.
So don't,
bigger it is, like this piece, you will lose it.
Okay.
You take the whole piece.
Leave my finger, you have to
you have
up
to,
and down. Don't
you have to press, finger. You have to have, bigger it is, look at
more it takes.
Look at
yes.
And more it takes away.
Thank you.
So after walking down, rushing down the mountain, we reached the village of Malana.
There's now a road going down there, but before you had to walk like 20, 24 k's to get there, like 2 days. Now, because of all the dams that are building in this area, it's easy to access, but still it's a very pretty steep climb up to the village. But once you are in the village, you are in a total different world.
Hey guys, in the end you arrived.
These guys are probably the direct descendants of Alexander the Great's troops left in this area during their conquering of Asia.
You cannot touch the people, you cannot touch the houses, we're not allowed to eat with them.
This place was very hidden in the mountain, and it was isolated.
Everything they need, they get from the mountain. Okay, so the way they build their houses without nails, the wood, even the stones for the roof. And Franco Casaloni tells us that in older times, the only two things that people needed was salt and oil.
Franco, can you ask the guy for a bottle of water?
Yes. Here, we cannot go inside the shop because they sell eatable items. So they will come all impure. It's better not touch for us.
They was letting a few sacks of wool. They was going away, and the locals from down looking how many, and changing with salt and rice, and going away. And the Malana people, they was going and taking with no even look in the others.
In the last 100 years, or even the last 150 years, charas has replaced wool as a form of barter. So these mountain people live this life totally self-sufficient, and they use charas to buy the few things that they can't obtain from the mountain.
To see Malana people, it was really another confirmation of the fact that cannabis is integrating part of the most special cultures on this planet.
Charas is people's freedom in these areas.
Okay, Shumaru, after meeting you in May, after your all your problems we had, we decided to give you a beautiful house in your village of Malana. And we're starting now, and we hope it's going to be ready before the winter. And we made a nice plaque for you, because this is a holy village. We cannot touch each other. We can also not touch the house, so we're going to put it down here. And we hope it will bring you a lot of prosperity and a lot of good luck for the rest of your life. And here's the plate and your house. We donated this house to Samaru. We lost both his parents. He's an orphan when he was 4 and 7 years old, first his father and then his mother. Now he's 18 and has nothing. He just sleeps in his shed and only has a few sheep and one pot field. So we decided to give him a nice house, to give him a little bit more luck than he had in the past.
We did a lot of work for the Greenhouse Foundation in the past. Most of the work is helping people with good seeds and in other ways. We have never given any attention to the public about our foundation, because it is questionable for some people. But now in the situation is changing in the world with the cannabis. Cannabis is getting more accepted. Cannabis is getting more legal around in the world. People are realizing that cannabis is not that bad at all in the end. And also us becoming more and more popular on YouTube with like more than 20 million hits. We decided that if we go open with the Greenhouse Foundation, maybe we can get more funds and do more things in the future.
After a good night of rest in the guest house in Malana, we started a really long walk, really steep walk, and we reached one of the most secluded valleys in the area. The locals call it Rally Touch. It's the Valley of the Devils. We were a little bit shaky on that walk because we heard rumors the night before that over 200 police officers were on the way to our area to cut down cannabis plants and to perform their so-called duties.
And this is a whole game between the politicians, the farmers and the police. It's a very sad situation.
The war on drugs takes on very interesting dimensions when you come to India. You've got hundreds of policemen that are paid to climb up the mountain and try and just cut. And the time it takes them to cut one plant is the time it takes someone to rub a plant. So this is futile expenditure of energy, and it just must be really demoralizing for them. It's also quite fantastic for me that in the mountains protect the people the way they do. The mountains, yeah, just make it impossible.
Yes. Wow, look at this, guys. Look at plants here. How high are we?
We are 3,028 meters.
So we're 600-700 meters up today.
Yeah, 600 meters up we started it, yeah.
This is the valley of Rally Touch, Simon.
Rally Touch, yes.
Okay. The valley of the devil. Well, now, today, we have to see what we do in the end of the day, because there's 200 police down there.
Yeah.
So if we come back, all our luggage safe. If we have to do an emergency evacuation, we go down right to the pass, because they're going to search up to the glacier, maybe. We don't know yet. We will hear this afternoon.
Amazing valley, eh?
Yeah.
Well, basically, what we figured out up to now is that this side is the warmest side.
Yes.
And yeah. So it matures a little bit earlier.
It will keep a lot of sun.
And the advantage here, much more production.
Much
because
more.
Because they
much
can work range. 12 hours.
Of course.
In the other side where we made the hand
the
charas,
day is shorter.
It was only 7 hours. And here's 12 hours.
12 hours, son.
You're really freedom fighters here.
Yeah.
The police comes, cut the filth. They go more far away.
Have the police ever cut on this side?
Huh?
They cut. Also on this side?
Yeah, because they know.
Now the European community is giving them 10 million euros to cut down the plants. So what they did, basically they're separating the money. They're giving a little bit here and a little bit there. And the farmers just went up a little higher and put more fields.
Yeah. And also the funny part is that the cops they send up here to cut the plants, they themselves smoke charas, they rub, it's in their culture, their families do it.
In the daytime they come, they cut the plants. In the evening time, they ask to the locals some charas to smoke.
Yes, yeah.
They know this culture for them.
And then they get drunk, you know? Yeah. And then you see also here the alcohol. Yeah.
And more, they promise it to the locals to grow chick beans, to have a good price instead of growing charas.
How much did they offer them?
They offer them 80 rupees per kilo.
In 80?
80.
80. How much did they get?
And they get 6.
You see?
6.
So the government promised them, you change your crop.
And now they are coming to cut the plants more. And for these people, nothing. What they will eat in this winter?
Beautiful plants, eh, Franco?
Yes. Very nice. Full of resin.
Yeah, but here they have the sunlight nearly the whole day, eh?
Yes. And now they have an oily resin. It's hot, the sun.
Wow.
Wow, man.
Here, one of the best creams of the area comes.
Really beautiful.
Yeah, man, it's really jungly style. They, you know?
This massive
they rub, and where they rub, the seeds fall down, and where the seeds fall down, it grows.
Yeah, but you see the different phenotypes here?
In the middle of.
That's why you never, never get the same cream or charas in this whole area in India.
No,
in the
it's
whole
variation.
Place.
And you can see also on the plants that they are really resistant, eh? Because, I mean, for the kind of roughness they go through climate-wise and altitude-wise, they're pretty healthy and pretty clean. Eh?
Yeah. But you see, now it's the perfect time for the harvest. Eh? You see the plants are turning yellow, end of the season, autumn. The crystals are double as the size as the other side of the mountains.
Yeah, much more.
A little bit different again than the Malawi style, the African style, where they put a whole pile, eh?
Yeah.
Here they throw the hand, you see?
Yeah.
You
yeah.
see them lying everywhere. Yeah. And in Africa they put little piles everywhere because the birds eat them.
What smells you get? You get the sweet.
Right? You get the sweet, you get the minty, you get many. I got many.
I can make a bowl now.
Hold me finish.
So here's the end result. A very nice piece of jungly cream. Look at this. Franco, you as a boom man, you should light it up.
Yeah.
Bambolina. Bam!
Very nice.
Very nice.
Very sweet.
Man, the mellow flavor.
So this is Rally Touch here, huh?
Rally Touch.
Can our friend explain a little bit the story about this Devil's Valley?
This place. Here was the place of Devil. His name was Rally. Then touch means field.
Yeah.
And he was eating a man, taking his clothes, and going in the house of this man where his brother was living, with the same face of the man eaten. But here, the devils, they can have the face, the same face of the man, but they have
a heel.
Heel here, in the bottom of the feet.
Okay.
So his brother recognized it. This is a devil. Then when he recognized this, he gave to the devil a lot of food, so the devil was sleeping. And the night time, he was putting this scissor they used to cut wool to the ships. They are big.
Yeah. Huh?
In the fire, it was very hot. Then in the night time, while the devil was sleeping, he put in the eyes of the devil.
Okay.
And the devil died. So since that time, here people can stay. And this is the place maintains the name of this devil.
I've been before in this area and I know there's a very, very nice field, but we have to pass a dam and a lot of security things. But luckily, one of our guides had some connections to a high-ranking police officer. There's a very big project going on building dams. And the aspects of the environment are totally thrown overboard.
Even though they're doing something good to the eyes of the world because they are creating so-called green energy, the way they are doing it is just nasty. They are overruling any logic, any environmental rule. They are putting lives of people at risk, and the condition of living of the workers there are inhumane, insane, that not even animals live like that.
Hi, guys.
Hi, guys.
How long you work here? Where are you from?
I'm India.
You're India?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Which area?
District Chamba, Himachal Pradesh. In this state.
Madhya Pradesh.
Yes, yes.
When you look at these projects, you can see they are economic hitman projects. They are projects cooked up by consultants somewhere.
How much they pay you?
Stay with me. Nothing.
They pay nothing?
Yeah.
Bad pay?
Maybe 6,000, 7,000.
Rupees?
Rupees.
100 euros. It's 3 euros a day.
And you make only 7,000 a month, and you have to pay also the food then?
Yes, yes, of course.
But do you know how many people die in the dam, making the dam or not?
Not just 15, 20 people die.
Okay? Here?
Yes, yes.
15, 20 people, accident?
Yes, yes.
And family get money? No.
No facility for them in this company.
No person get money in this company?
Like my friend was speaking, we are owner of our life, and when the road and the dam will come, we will have to work and to live for somebody other. And that's true.
Cheers.
Cheers, sir.
Cheers, nice to meet you. What's your name?
What I've heard, and this is the good thing in the end, is that the European community is putting 10 million euros one way and the other by supporting the narcotic police here in India to cut down all those plants. And basically what I think is happening now is that this money is divided between politicians, police and farmers. Because what you see happening now is the farmers are pulling a little bit away from the road, so it's not in your face totally anymore, but they're putting it up more in the mountains. And they're putting three times more up.
Until a few years ago, there were actually shops where you could buy this stuff legal all around India. So, you know, it's very difficult to change the attitude of someone when for thousands of years has been part of your culture.
How long have you worked with the police?
Well, 23 years.
23 years? Very long, eh?
Yeah.
It's good job?
86, yeah.
Don't pay good?
Everybody respect the police.
Yeah. Everybody respect the police, yeah. And many plants, eh, just per day. The police, can you cut down the plants? Many work, eh?
Yeah, cannabis plants.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you cut down the plants for the local, maybe go
yeah,
crazy,
busy, yeah?
So what do you do?
Well,
cannot do nothing.
Yeah.
They're angry, no?
Yeah.
How many times you cut down in a year?
4 or 5 times.
So all police also smoke here, like the farmer, everybody?
Yeah, it's part of the country.
Too smoke. But, and many people also drink, eh?
Yeah.
So what do you think is better, smoking or drinking?
Drinking
better?
Smoking
no good?
Never.
And the funny part is, when you talk to a police officer about this, you also can say, in Europe they will say, yeah, no, we know that cannabis plants are good, but we're just doing our job, we have to cut them down, and we know that alcohol is much worse. Well, here you have a situation where you interrogate a police officer, the highest ranking police officer of the area, and he just basically says, blame in your face, no, alcohol is much better for you, and we should not smoke the charas.
So what we tell our children, drinking better or smoking better?
Drinking better.
But also from alcohol, many people die, eh?
No.
That problem? No?
No.
It's just really, really sad that you have everyone jumping on the alcohol thing, and yet charas is a much more gentler culture, you know, it makes people shunty, it makes people think.
In thousands of years, in billions of smokers, never one died for that, and now they are going to brainwash people, not only the police, in the school, in the books.
Where the best charas come from? From Pradesh. Where the best one come from?
Good climate and good charas. For if you take one joint,
yeah.
For 3 and 4 or shanti.
Look at this, look at the stalks here, incredible.
Wow, amazing the smell, really
incredible smell. Who are you? Pleased to meet you. I'm Franco.
Oops, sorry.
Franco, come here. I'm coming.
Wow.
Look at this, eh?
Mind-blowing place.
Look at here. Everywhere.
Really beautiful.
Stocks are impressive.
See, they have all males here.
Full of males, yeah. I think they leave the males in some areas so that they can make enough seeds for the next year. But for sure here they pull them because you can find them on the ground already a lot.
Cut it off. Yeah, that's the one.
What a lady.
Wow. Look at this, hey?
What a lady. Amazing.
Look what a strange smell
really
this one
amazing.
Is. Hardly any smell this
yeah,
one.
But it has a fruitiness that the others don't have though. The others were really mintiness and this one has a fruitiness in it. Beautiful.
You see that? The birds are in the where you don't normally don't
directly
see
directly from the stalk. Instead of a single pre-flower, she's shooting bud from the stalk.
How many seeds we have? We have some seeds.
We have 15.
Should we take this plant with us? Cross the river with it.
The next day we were planning to reach Tosh, so we got on our bikes.
What every person that travels through India should do or did is travel around on the big Royal Enfield, the Bullet.
The first time I was in India was 89. I bought a second-hand model in Bombay. Then I traveled with that 12,000 kilometers all around India.
The Royal Enfield is just an absolute classic, and as soon as we got to India, we saw how many there were, our tongues were just hanging out. So we quickly made a plan and arranged to hire some. Beautiful, beautiful experience.
Actually a nice morning, but pretty soon we see thick nasty clouds approaching the sky, and in a matter of a few hours it starts raining.
In one way or the other, fortunately or not fortunately, we walked in the mountains for 5-6 hours in very bad conditions, a lot of heavy rain, and we find this field.
Jesus Christ, look here guys.
Destruction, eh?
Incredible what the police did, eh? Here you see what happens with European community money. But they leave a whole part there, eh?
Yeah, because they...
You think they have a deal with the farmers or something?
I think maybe it was coming too late, because you see, it's usual.
Maybe it started raining and they run all the way.
Yeah, they run away.
The surprise was not a good one, because as we get there, we realized that most of the field we were supposed to visit was already being chopped down by the cops.
And the funny thing again is here that there's so many police officers, but the field was so big they only could cut half of it. But at least you see the destroying of the plant happening right in front of you. We just arrived in that field and all the plants were cut down and some is left. And then at the same time you realize that this is the food for the farmer for his whole year and now he's gonna suffer.
I am scared to walk on all these buds.
Somehow a quarter of the field was still standing and what was still standing was pretty damn amazing.
This one smells really strange. Yeah, and this one is pineapple mango. This is the pineapple mango story, full.
Just a little bit more and we are into the snow mountains. We are lucky the rain stops. A little bit.
A little bit, but the plants are so wet they cannot make a hand.
No, we can't rub any charas today because of the rain.
Hey, look at this mane. I will cut it and bring down. Look at this mane.
Wow.
What's that?
Looks like a feminized male. Wow. That looks like a feminized male.
A male.
It looks like a reverse
nice, eh?
Male.
Yeah. Nice, eh?
But also like a straight female.
Yeah.
We had to make a small fire on the way down to try to dry our clothes and dry ourselves and warm up a little bit. And that's something that just happens, you know, when you are strain hunting, you have to keep flexible. No problem, it's part of the game. It's actually a lot of fun if you have the right spirit for it.
everybody thinks only in Holland we have coffee shops. But I just came back from California. There are 4,000 coffee shops. There are coffee shops in Spain. There are coffee shops all over the world. But they don't have a license, but they are there, and the police tolerate these coffee shops. And also here in India, I think there's a few hundred coffee shops.
Tosh is a very colorful little village all the way up into Parvati Valley. And we had a contact there in a really nice guest house, the Himalaya Gold Guest House. And the atmosphere is really like a coffee shop. You sit down and they bring you a nice hot cup of tea, and you can sample different varieties of charas, of cream, and they have chillums, everything is arranged.
You can buy your hash there, and you can smoke. And people from all over India come there, and the police, the local police, come there to smoke with us. So yeah, I think it's pretty relaxed after all the stories that we heard.
So in Buntar City, we had the chance to sample the local cuisine. It was quite a hectic, quite chaotic experience, but the food was really tasty.
We had a really nice lunch in a traditional Indian restaurant with the tandoor there and some dal and some chapatis.
It was nice. Nice to see how the locals enjoy the food. After that, we had quite a long trip in the car, all the way climbing this nasty mountain road. We had a few problems two or three times with the car. We had to watch out because the conditions of our tires were pretty scary. But we got to the top of this beautiful mountain where we camped again. It was a very nice night. We had a beautiful moonlight. We made a big fire, and it was really a very special experience.
वो समझो कि तेरा 14 साल का था वो सब कुछ
जा प्योर है 55 इयर्स
ही रबिंग एंड ही लर्न फ्रॉम हिज फादर
ही लर्न फ्रॉम हिज फादर
इन हिज बेस्ट डेज हाउ मेनी ग्राम्स अ डे कुड ही रब
4-5 ग्राम का 4-5 ग्राम
4-5 ग्राम वन डे व्हाट टाइम ऑफ द ईयर इज इट गुड टू मेक द चारास
It's like in between end of September to middle of November.
End of September to middle of November, until the first snow come.
Till the first snow come. And sometimes
can you show the hands? Look how black. Incredible. Wow. Can he explain a little bit more about the medicinal aspects of the ganja?
He's saying it's mostly using for stomach pain.
For stomach pain? Okay.
And that's all I have in his. For sleeping, possibly.
For sleeping. So for sleeping and for stomach pain, they used it here very long time.
It appeared to be like a third day in the touch.
And they're using mostly the seeds for, that's what he's saying, seeds for oil.
Yeah, for oil. What do they do with the oil?
Oil for cooking.
For cooking?
Yes. Huh. It's very good.
It's very healthy.
And natural, organic.
And what is the good way to make, to finish the product?
Like this.
Okay. So he turns his finger, eh?
Yeah.
And it must be in the sun or in the shadow?
Starting from the sun,
Yeah. But if sometimes too much sun and too much hot, then it's more melting, so
yeah, shadow. Yeah. But now it's morning, it's okay?
Yes, now it's morning.
Okay.
After 4 or 5 hours of walk, we arrived on this amazingly big field with our guide. And for us, it was like young kids in the candy shop.
In this area, actually, the cultivation is a little bit more spread out. And you can see that the phenotypes are adapted a bit more to the to being lower in altitude. So the sativa character manifests itself a little bit more.
So for me, as a sativa connoisseur, it was nicer to see the sativas growing a little bit lower than the indica plants growing higher.
The plants have not this really broad leaf like it comes out at 3,000 meters. Here we talk about something that stays a little bit more in the original sativa leaf shape, and the smells are a bit more minty, a bit more fresh, a bit more piney.
So this is the plant in the big field that we're gonna pick out for the seeds.
Look at the structure and the mango flavors, man.
Looks a little bit like the Ultrace too, not the mango one.
Yeah.
Wow, that what an incredible beautiful field, huh? How many hectares is this? How many plants?
Many.
And you see they pull a lot of males, eh? It's the first field where you, in the high up in the mountains where you see they pull a lot of males.
Yeah, they definitely got rid of the males a while ago. They're already rotting away on the ground.
And look at the difference in phenotypes here. Some sativas here between us.
Yeah.
Incredible, huh?
Yeah, even though I have to say there is less difference overall compared to the fields in 3,000 meters in the other valleys.
Yeah. There the higher you go, the more they change into indica, eh?
Yeah.
And here you see a little bit more sativa leaves. Yeah. We're gonna get some seeds out of these plants.
Yeah, for sure. Wow. There's like, and still so clean, Franco. How do you do that? So clean.
There's just so many flavors.
You sure there's crystals on this little one? Look here.
Amazing.
Yeah, it must be amazing to grab as well. This is the rub plant for the real cream.
Wow.
Look how sticky this one is. Look at this.
This side. For me rubbery. This for me is rubber.
I fresh feel rubber. That one of that one of.
You know, fresh tire of truck.
This
rubber.
One, this one has strawberries.
There's
the salami again.
And strawberry here.
Again.
Right next to that.
Man, this is really like
candy garden.
Look how weird this.
You see this one?
Whoa, this is the weird sativa.
Look, the resin on this one here. Wow.
Shiny. Real shiny. This one. Wow, it's bitterish, like very green moss like.
The crystals here are completely under the leaves, see that?
Yeah.
Like what we do indoor.
Yeah, and only the bark.
You see?
But you see how the structure stays quite open, eh? It's tuck, tuck, tuck.
But look here, if you see from this side on the sun, it's one big shiny thing.
Yeah.
And even the leaves, you know the little bud leaves? They're totally
covered.
They came up 3 years ago in our office to do something new. We were very big under pressure in Holland of the right extremist Christian parties. And we decided on the office we should create more awareness and show more what is cannabis about, what's the background of cannabis, in which cultures is it used, where does it come from.
One little journey has become a multitude of journeys where we're following a plant and we're going to regions which are very, very remote, that have had very, very few outsiders. But also kind of approach which makes it quite different is that we're not coming here to buy anything or to buy charas or to buy, you know, which is was what people ordinarily expect often when outsiders come here. We're coming to these places to learn.
That's what's behind Strain Hunter and the Greenhouse Foundation. It's the feeling of hunting for something unique and bringing it back and preserving it, but also the feeling of leaving something good to the people and the cultures and the environments that donate this beautiful plant to us.
And I think at one point, I hope we will be a part of the legalization process, that people can show this movie to other people who are against cannabis and give them more awareness about the plant and see how important and how valuable this plant could be to society.
It's just a continuing project. It's just an ongoing mission. Strain hunters are people who can't sit quiet for too long, you know, we get bored easily. So we gotta keep moving.